365 days, 365 messages God has in store for you each year. You've Got Mail from God by Edgar Redondo Ramirez. Let's see what God has in store for you today. Today is April 2nd, 2022. Today's title is Holiness by Association. But before we begin, let's have a word of prayer. Dear God, bless us with the ability to receive your message and help us to see the truth in every situation we are in throughout the day. In the name of Jesus, amen. You must be holy because I, the Lord your God, am holy. Leviticus 19:2. When holiness refers to God, it expresses his greatness, justice, and perfection. It is his character. But when the word is applied to things or people, it does not refer to a holiness that is inherent to objects or individuals, but rather a holiness that is derived from God. Since holy means set aside or separated, holiness is maintained only and exclusively as long as that person or object is still related to God. It is holiness by association. For instance, Tiff is holy because it belongs to God. He stood out in school for being upright in everything, a good student, a good friend, and an excellent citizen. All his classmates admired the way he dressed neatly, his generosity, and rare nobility. He is a strange young man, his advisor said at a staff meeting, but the principal was not very convinced about what his teacher said of the student. So he said, "Such beauty cannot be true in this age in which we live. There are no longer any young people like the one you are describing." The school was looking for a young man who met the necessary requirements to recommend him to the town council for the next elections. They had enthusiastic long-term plans to choose one of their students, launch him as a candidate, and thus forge a professional politician who would later be able to run as city mayor. But none of them could have imagined the student's answer when he was brought before the administrative committee and told about the plan of all the benefits he would get from accepting their proposal. "It's an honor that a prestigious school like this one would think of me for such a special project, but someone else has already thought of me before I accepted his invitation. I'm a Seventh-day Adventist Christian, and I have been set aside by God for his service. I will major in theology and become a minister of the gospel." When he heard the young man's answer, the school principal commented, "I knew this boy had a special drive. He is a saint." Evidently, a person is holy when they have been set aside to serve God. Today, God tells you, "You are holy because you are my son or daughter. Live accordingly